Good morning, students. Till now we have seen question number up to question number 12 of the exercise 13.4. Now today we will see from question number 13. Now question number 13 are based on variance of the random variable and standard deviation. Now students, this formula we have seen in the concept of random variable and its probability distribution, but again we are recalling it. So now variance of x can be defined as expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. Now when we know that expectation of x square, that means sigma x square into probability of xi, sigma xi square into probability of xi, and the standard deviation, that is the square root of the variance of x. That is, you can find out first variance and then using it we will find out the standard deviation. And as we can know that in the variance we require the expectation of x, that is the mean also. So first we have to find out the mean and then variance, that is ex, expectation of x square, then variance, and at the end the standard deviation. So let us start with the today's concept, question number 13. Now question number 13, let x denote the sum of the numbers obtained when the die are rolled. Find the variance and the standard deviation. Now students, we know that whenever we have to solve some question, first we require the sample space and the x. Here sample space is of the event two dice are rolled. Now we know that how many outcomes are there for this, so we are not writing this. I have written only the event, that is two dice are rolled. Now x, the x is sum of the numbers. Now sum of the numbers, we know that on two dice the minimum sum will be 2 and maximum is 12. So here the outcome for the x, or the variable for the the values for the random variable are 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So now students, let us start with the first. If x is equals to 2, then what can be the probability of 2? Listen, again we have to prepare first the probability distribution, because to find out the variance and standard deviation we will require the probability distribution first. So we will find out it. If x is equals to 2, that means probability of 2, that means sum of the dice should be 2, and that is only one outcome, that is 1 1. If we got 1 1 on the board die, then the sum will be 2. So therefore our probability is 1 out of 36. As we know that 2 dice are rolled, so total outcome will be 36. Now x is equals to 3, that means probability of 3. So probability of 1 2 and 2 1, 2 elements, so 2 by 36. Similarly x is equals to 4, then probability of 4, we have to consider all the elements where sum can be 4. So 2 2, 3 1 and 1 3, so 3 by 36. Similarly 5, then probability of 5 will be 1 4, 4 1, 3 2 and 2 3, so 4 out of 36. Now 6, x is equals to 6, then probability of 6 will be all the outcome where sum is a 6. So 1 5, 5 1, 2 4, 4 2 and 3 3, so 5 by 36. X is equals to 7, then these according elements are there, 6 by 36. X is equals to 8, then sum are 8, all the element we have considered, so 5 by 36. Similarly we have to check for the 9, 10 and 11. For x is equals to 9, probability of 9 is this 4 element, so 4 by 36. X is equals to 10, 3 element, 3 by 36. 11, 2 element, 2 by 36, and 12, 1 element, so 1 by 36. Now I hope you have understood how to find the probability for the given random variable. Now according to this, we have create a probability distribution table. Now you can see this, here the probability distribution table we have made. Now, as we have to find out the variance, so first we have to find out the expectation of the x, that is mean. So mean is equals to sigma xi into pxi. So here xi, and this is your pxi, 2 into 1 upon 1 by 36, 3 into 2 by 36, 4 into 3 by 36 according variable and its probability distribution, 5 into 4 by 36, 6 into 5 by 36 and so on up to 12 into 1 by 36. Okay, so this is the formula for mean. Now as we find out the formula, just calculate this. 2 by 36, 3 2s are 6 by 36, 4 3s are 12 by 36, 5 4s are 20 by 36, 6 5s are 30 by 36, 7 6s are 42 by 36 and so on we calculate. So the final answer is 252 by 36, that is 7. So this is our expectation of x. Now next is we have to find out expectation of x square, because in the formula for the variance this is required. So what it is? Xi square into pxi. So xi is 2, so 2 square into its probability 1 by 36. Nothing to do, student, in the last formula where ex is there, okay, that we consider the x size 2, then 3, 4, 6, sorry, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on, and here x square, so 2 square, 3 square, otherwise probability distribution is the same, 1 by 36, 3 square, 2 by 36, 4 square, 3 by 36, 5 square into 4 by 36 plus 6 square, 5 by 36, so on. So here multiplied 2 square 4, so 4 by 36, 3 square here, 3 square 9, 9 2s are 18, so 18 by 36, 4 square 16, 16 3s are 48 by 36, 5 square 25, 25 4s are 100 by 36, 6 square 36, 36 5s are 180 by 36, 7 square 49, 49 into 6, that is 294 by 36, 8 square 64, 64 into 5, calculate it, it is 320 by 36, 9 square 81, 81 into 4, 324 divided by 36, 10 square 100, 100 into 3, obviously 300 by 36, 11 square 121 into 2, 242 by 36, 12 square 144 into 1, so 144 by 36, and then you calculate sum, the total one, so 1974 divided by 36, okay, that is 54.83. So here we have expectation of x square. Now we have to find out the variance. Now variance is ex square, that is expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. So this is 54.83 minus 7 square, that is 54.83 minus 49, that is 5.83. So in this equation, first part we have found. Now standard deviation. Now standard deviation is under root of variance of x, that is 5.83. So student, we know that how to take a 583. Okay, this is between 24 and 25 square of, so it is 2.41. We can take it, you can count it by the calculation, or you can directly take it, or you can put it as a under root of 5.83. Okay, so this is the over of the first equation, that is equation number 30. In this, we have find two things, that is variance of x and standard deviation of x. Again, I am repeating, whenever we have to find out the variance of x or standard deviation, first you have to see the random variable in the formula, in the equation. Then, according to the random variable, find out the probability distribution. After that, you have to find out the mean of the random variable, that is expectation of the x, then expectation of the x square, and then in the variance and standard deviation formula, just substitute all the value and you will get the answer. Okay. So let us start with the next question number 14. Before this, we are again just a quick review of this question. Again, let us start question number 13 here. So sample space, then sum of the x, that is our random variable, sum of the numbers. So according sum of the number, this is our sample space, and this is according it, it's a probability distribution. I hope you understood how to find out the probability distribution. It is easy. 9, then 10, 11, 12, then probability distribution. After this, we have find it. Expectation of the x. Here you can see the calculation again. This is the calculation. So we are getting 7. Then we have found expectation of x square. In this, nothing we have to do. Only 2 square, 3 square. That is xi square you have to consider. And then the calculation. And this is expectation of x square. Then variance of x. It is expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. And the answer is 5.83. Then standard deviation of the x, that is under root of the variance. So 5.83, that is answer will be 2.841. Now let me start with the next question. Okay. So next question is question number 14. A class has 15 students whose ages are 14, 17, 15, 14, 21, 17, 19, 20, 16, 18, 20, 17, 16, 19 and 20 years. One student is selected in such a manner that each has the same chance of being chosen, and age x of the student is recorded. What is the probability distribution of x? Find the mean variance and the standard deviation. So here let me find out first the data we have given. Here the age of the student is given. Okay, age of the students are 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 and 21. But you can observe that age of the 15 student, in that two students having the same age, 14 and 14. So here we can write on number of students, that is the frequency of the student with age 14, that is 2, 15, 1, 16, then how many 16, 1 and 2, so 2, 17, 1, 2 and 3. Is there any? No. So 17, 3. With age 18, only one student. 19, 1 and 2. So 2, 20, 1, 2 and 3. So 23, 21, only one student. So 1. So this is the data we have. Age and the according age the number of students. So now we have to, what is our x? X is the age of the student. Look, and age x of the selected student. This means that random variable is the age of the student. So we can write down here x as the age of the student. Now total students are 15. So we can directly also prepare now the probability distribution, but here I have find out the probability also. There's a probability of 14. So how many students having 14 age? So 2 student out of 15. So 2 by 15. So similarly 15, 1 by 15. So you can prepare it directly also using this table. 14, so 2 by 15. 15, 1 by 15. 16, 2 by 15. 17, 3 by 15. Probability of 18, 1 by 15, 19, 2 by 15, 20, 3 by 15 and 21, 1 by 15. And just arrange this all data in the probability distribution table. Okay, after the probability distribution, we require mean. Now, formula of mean, we know how to find out xi into pxi. So, 14 into 2 by 15 plus 15 into 1 by 15. plus 16 into 2 by 15 plus 17 into 3 by 15 plus 18 into 1 by 15 plus 19 into 2 by 15 plus 20 into 3 by 15 and 21 into 1 by 15. So we know how this find out mean. Just complete the calculation and you will get the answer. So let us see the calculation here. So this is the calculation. You can see this. And then your answer is 263 divided by 15, that is 17.53. Now variance. So variance formula is sigma x square, that is equals to expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. Now expectation of x we have found. So we will find out expectation of the x square. So expectation of x square is sigma xi square into pxi. Now again we will continue the formula. 14 square into 2 by 15, 15 square into 1 by 15, 16 square into 2 by 15, 17 square into 3 by 15, 18 square into 1 by 15, 19 square into 2 by 15 and 20 square upon 3 by 15 and 21 square upon 1 by 15. Okay, and now let us see the calculation. 14 square, 196 into 2 by 15, 15 square or 225 into 1 by 15, 16 square, 256 into 2 by 15, 17 square, 289 into 3 by 15, 18 square, 324 into 1 by 15, 19 square, 361 into 2 by 15, 20 square, 400 into 3 by 15, 21 square, 441 into 1 by 15. So now student, this is the calculation. You can see, just take the multiplication and complete the calculation. So your answer will be 4683 divided by 50, that is 312.2. So this we have got expectation of the x square. So here we have expectation of x square as a 312.2. So now let me find out the variance. So variance is expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square, that is 312.2 minus 17.53 whole square. Just multiply 17.53 square, you found this is 307.30. So 312.2 minus 307.30, so 4.9. Here student, we have taken approximate 17.53. If you use here more points or more decimal, then your value will be nearby 4.78. Your value will be more nearly 4 point something. I think so its value is 4 point. Answer is given backside different, but it is nearby answer. So we can consider this also. It is 4.78. Okay. Backside answer is 4.78. It is only because of the taking the decimal points. If you take the more decimal point, then here the answer will be different, and according the this your answer will be different. So 4.9. So now let us find out the standard deviation. Now standard deviation is variance of x, that is under root of 4.9, which is nearby 2.21. so we have find out the standard deviation, that is 2.21. so now let us start with next equation, equation number 15. In a meeting, 70% of the member favor and 30% oppose a certain proposal. So there are 70% students are in the favor and 30% are in the oppose. A member is selected at random and we take x is equals to 0 if he oppose and x is equals to 1 if he is in favor. Then find the expectation of x and variance of x. This one is the easy equation. Here x is equal to 0, then he opposed, so probability of 0 is 30%, 0.3. x is equals to 1 if he in favor, so probability of 1, it is given 70%, so 0.7, sorry, here 0.7. So x probability distribution is x 0 1 and probability of x is 0.3 and 0.7. Now you can easily find out the expectation of x. I am not repeating the calculation, I am just giving you the overview. This is the expectation of x. You can complete this calculation. So expectation of x is 0.7. Expectation of x square, xi square into pxi, here you can see it is again 0.7. then you find out the variance of the x. Your equation only you have to find out the expectation of x and variance of the x. So answer is 0.7 and 0.21. I hope you understood this equation. Now another two equation are depend on the same method, but they are MCQ type equation. So let us see equation number 16 first. The mean number of the numbers obtained on throwing a dice having written 1 on 3 faces, 2 on 2 faces and 5 on 1 faces is. Options are given A, B, C and D. So first understood, in this topic we have given a die which is type of different. It's 3 edges having 1. That means at the place of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, they have placed 1 on the 3 faces, 2 on 2 faces and 5 on 1. So that's why here probability distribution there is 1. 1 is on 3 faces, so 3 by 6. 2 is in 2 faces, so 2 by 6 and 1 by 6. So now you can calculate expectation of x, xi into pxi, and your answer is 2. Okay, so this is the easy equation, equation number 16. Now let me see equation number 17. So 17 is, suppose that two cards are drawn at the random from the deck of the card. Let x be the number of the aces obtained, then the value of expectation of x is A, 37 upon 221, B, 5 by 13, C and D. So let us see what they have given. We have to select two cards, okay, which are drawn at the random from the deck of the card, and x be the number of the aces obtained. Now students, when we find out the numbers, so there is possibility. So x can be 0, 1 or 2. There is no S card. X can be 0, 1 and 2. There is no S card, only 1 S card and 2. So now we don't know, so therefore we will start from x is equals to 0, then probability of 0. Probability 0 means out of 2, no S card is selected. So 4 will be 4, out of 52. 52 we have 4 S card and 48 different than S. Okay, 48 are different than S is or no S card. So therefore now probability of 0, so we have to select 0 from the S's. So 4 C 0 and 48 C 2 out of 50 C 52 C 2. So let us see the calculation. 4 C 0 value is 1, 48 C 2, so 48 into 47 upon 1 into 2, 52 C 2, so 52 into 51 upon 1 into 2. So now you just cut the simple calculation, 1 by 2 cut, here out of 2, 24 2's are 48 and 26 2's are, so your answer is 1128 upon 1326. Here further calculation we can do, but in the other one, the denominator we will take common, that's why 1326 we have kept here. X is equals to 1, then probability of 1 is 4C1 into 48C1 upon 42C2. X is equals to 1. That means we have to select one S card and one non S card. So 4C1 into 48C1 upon 52C2. So this equals to 4 into 48 upon 52 into 51 upon 1 into 2. Again, we just cut 2. So, 26 2s are 48 4s are 192. And 26 into 51, that is 1326. That is x is equals to 1. Now, x is equals to 2. That means probability of 2. That means both selected card is of S. So, 4C2 into 48C0. So, 52C2. So, we can see this 4 by 3 upon 1 into 2. 48C0, that is 1. So, that's why I have written like this. 52C2. So, 52 into 51 upon 1 into 2. Again, the same 1 by 2 and 1 into 2 and 1 into 2 will be cut. 2 to cut. Here, 4. So, it cut by 2. So, 2 2s are 4 and 26 2s are 42. So, your final answer is 6 by 1326. So, this is our probability distribution. X, 0, 1 and 2. Its probability distribution 1128 upon 1326, 192 upon this and 6. So, now only expectation of X we have to find out. So, let us find out the calculation sigma xi into pxi this. So, 204 by 1326. You can cut it by your own. Your answer will be 2 by 13. So, therefore, your answer is option D. So, with this, exercise 13.4 is completed. Now, in the next video, we will see the quick recap of this chapter and then we will start another chapter. Thank you and have a nice day.